winter isn't far off, and it's the most challenging season to forecast for our weather team.
So we asked our chief meteorologist, Mike Haddad, to give you a behind-the-scenes look at how a forecast comes together.
Yeah, guys, you know, a lot of factors come into play here, and while each season certainly poses its own challenges when it comes to forecasting, winter is certainly the winner when it comes to putting us meteorologists to the test. Will it be heavy snow or just flurries, damaging wind or a steady breeze, a major ice storm or a cold rain? WMUR meteorologists walk a fine line when we forecast New Hampshire's winter weather, especially because our longer-term forecasts often change day to day.
Sometimes we are talking about something 5 days away that really won't develop until a day before out over the ocean, and so that's always in the back of your mind as well.
To start a forecast, we look at data, including pressure, temperature, wind, humidity, and much more, to analyze the current weather and predict the next several hours.
Steadiest rain pivots through and then out of here by, say, 2, 3 in the morning on Friday.
To go beyond that, we're guided by computer models, mathematical programs that produce weather information for future times at specific locations and altitudes. They also produce a location of the jet stream, that fast-flowing ribbon of air that drives storms either right at us or away from us. One of the trickiest parts of forecasting a New Hampshire winter is figuring out where that critical rain-snow line will occur during a storm.
All it takes is an easterly wind coming off the ocean, a gentle breeze, and places on Hampton Beach are flipping from snow over to rain, yet just a few miles inland, Hampton Falls, Kensington, Exeter, they're all snowing to beat the band.
The difference in elevation in the Granite State are equally as important in determining precipitation types and amounts. A chilly rain at certain elevation may turn into a slippery glaze of ice elsewhere, while a cold rain in the valleys or at the coast could be a foot of snow 1 to 2,000 feet up. And of course, anytime we start tracking a storm early on, there's another big factor that could be the difference between getting a dusting or getting walloped. And it's one we sometimes can't figure out until the storm is almost on top of us.
And what's really important is the track, especially with nor'easters. If it goes just a little bit off toward the west, we could be looking at huge snow amounts. If it goes a little bit more out to the ocean, you could be looking at nothing.
Nor'easters, icy wind chills, snow squalls, cold rain, messy wintry mixes, and more. We will likely face it all this winter, and it will certainly be a challenge to forecast it.